Hi! In this video I will tell you about the settings in the Content Types tab, which is part of the Search Appearance settings. The default content types in WordPress are posts and pages. But there can also be additional content types, for example if you have an e-commerce website and you are using WooCommerce. You will also see a product content type listed here. We are now going to take a look at the settings for posts, but as you can see, the options are the same for your other content types. Let's take a look at the first switch. With this switch, you can determine whether you want your content to show up in the search results. Of course, if your site is live and you are ready to show it to the world, you want your content to appear in the search results. That is why we recommend you keep the default settings and leave the switch toggled to yes. If, for whatever reason, you want to hide your content, in this case your posts, just toggle the switch to no, and search engines won't show it in their results. The second switch gives you the option to hide the Yoast SEO settings. If you choose hide here, you won't see the Yoast SEO sidebar or meta box for your posts. Of course, I would not recommend that for posts. Our plugin's features can help you improve your SEO, so if you turn them off, you will be missing out on a lot. With the next two input fields, you can create a template for your SEO title and the meta description. We've already set some variables for the SEO title, but you can edit them as you see fit. And if you want to include a piece of information in all your meta descriptions by default, you can also add some variables to this field. For example, your site title. That will make sure that the name of your site is automatically added to all your meta descriptions. By the way, if you're not sure about which variables to use, you can always learn more about them by clicking the question mark in the lower right corner. For example, you can find a list of all the variables you can use if you click this link. Or you can click on this link to find out more about snippet variables in Yoast SEO. Then we also have the schema settings here. Let me tell you a bit more about that. We use schema.org markup, which is a specific type of code, to describe the content of your posts and pages to search engines. By default, Yoast SEO describes your pages with web page schema and your posts with article schema. In most cases, you won't need to change these default settings. But some users might want some more control over our schema output. If you are one of them, you can change the schema settings here. For example, if you choose the news article as a default article type, then all your posts will contain specific schema for news articles. Please be careful with this though, because we're dealing with default settings that will change the output for all your posts or pages. If you want to change the default settings for one individual post or page, you can do that in the schema settings in the Yoast SEO sidebar or meta box. Let's quickly go there, just so you know where to find these settings. Keep in mind though that by overriding the defaults, you may alter your schema markup in ways which don't make sense, or which are incomplete. And this may result in errors or unexpected behavior. Okay, back to the Content Types tab. The final input field over here, the Custom Fields option, is really only for developers to be able to add particular filters. So it's best to ignore that if you don't already know what you should do there. Now, we also have the pages settings here, but as I've mentioned before, the options are the same for each content type, so you should have no problem going through them by yourself. Good luck!